confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask the Blessed Mary, the Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
In the name of Almighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sin, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Seek the Lord while he may be found. Call him while he is near. Let the scoundrel forsake his way, and the wicked his thoughts. Let him turn to the Lord for mercy, to our God who is generous in forgiving. For my thoughts are not your thoughts, nor are your ways my ways, says the Lord. As high as the mountains are above the earth, so high are my ways above your ways, and my thoughts above your thoughts. The word of the Lord.
The Lord is near to all.
Praise you forever and ever.
Or am I not free to do as I wish with my own money? Are you envious because I am generous? Thus, the last will be first, and the first will be last. The Gospel of the Lord.
Part of the pandemic, I realized I was alone. alone now, and that I miss people that I was usually with. And so I haven't had that experience in a long time in my life. I was grateful for it, you know. It's one of the things that taught me, and to share the burdens, the bounty, the pain and the sorrow, the good times, the joy, and to bring that into the lives of others. That was Jesus' mission. The parable tells us about God and God's ways. They're not ours. Your ways are not my ways. Your thoughts are not my thoughts. So far are my ways above your ways and my thoughts above your ways, as it is the ocean for us. So it's a call to repentance, to look at those areas of our lives where we fall short, and to make a decision. Paul is making a decision here. The landowner made a decision to share the same. And they were upset because he treated them like them. Treated them the same. Boy, we got problems with that these days in spades. Oh, he made them just like us. That's right. He made us as one family. And nobody's excluded. Nobody gets more than the other. Salvation is given freely, not earned. So don't get the idea by this parable that we're going to earn anything from God. God gives generously, abundantly, continually. God's life is to love. That's what he calls us to. And then we will truly know what freedom is about. We will be free then to do and to live as God would live. So let's continue to listen to his word and let it run through our minds. Sometimes we filter the word through our politics and our way of thinking. If it doesn't jive, then it can't be God's word. It doesn't mean anything to me then. But we're to filter our ways through God's word. Bring it to God. Don't be afraid, because God loves us all. We're not earning this, you know. We didn't ask to be born. We didn't ask to be here. We didn't ask to live in this country. God welcomes all. And we're working towards that as the people of God, as the church, and as society. And so we thank the Lord for his gifts. His gifts. Paul reminds us over and over again that this salvation is not our doing. It's part of God's plan to do it for us, to prepare us for it. Let's rejoice. We've been chosen, and the one who chose us is the one who loved us more than we'll ever know. Today, tomorrow, whenever we've repented from everything, we still won't know the depth of his love. So let's rejoice. We're here to give thanks to God for what God has done and is doing. He provides a meal for us. We didn't earn it. It's a given. God provides. God's providence is a wonderful gift. That's what the providence comes from, providing. So God provides for our needs. Let's be grateful and rejoice.
I believe in one God, the Father, For Pope Francis and all who proclaim the gospel with their lives, especially teachers and missionaries, we pray to the Lord. For all who labor in the vineyards of peace, especially world and national leaders, we pray to the Lord. For all who are sick and struggling, especially the people in our Book of Intentions and on our parish prayer line, we pray to the Lord. For all who strive to end disease and suffering, especially doctors and medical researchers, we pray to the Lord. For all who are gathered here today and the ones watching at home, especially those most in need of our prayers, we pray to the Lord. We especially remember all our departed, especially Lon Hamilton. We pray to the Lord.
Generous God, you are near to all who call on you. Hear our prayers and grant them in your time. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you. dare to say,
Our God, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Lord, deliver us from the grave of every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of thy mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope of the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory of yours, and now and ever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Not on our sins, but on the faith of the Church, graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Mercy. is not the cup we bless and share. The blood of Christ our Lord, do not one cup, one loaf declare, our oneness in the Lord. You satisfy the hungry heart with gift of finest wheat. Come give to us, O saving Lord, the bread of life to eat. The mystery of your presence, Lord, no mortal tongue can tell, whom all the world cannot until comes in
seated. There are a few announcements this evening. We were able to provide food for 135 families at our mobile food pantry this past Friday. We are so grateful to the 32 people who helped out and for all who have been supporting this great outreach. 135 families is a tremendous amount of need in our area. Next weekend, we will have a special collection for Christ is Our Hope. It is the magazine for the Diocese of Joliet. There is a purple envelope in your packet from the parish for that second collection. Tickets are still available from our Knights of Columbus for their fall raffle. Please see the bulletin or parish website for who to contact to get your tickets. I don't know if you really want to, because I know I'm winning. Volunteers are needed for our religious education program. There are many possibilities to help out. We encourage you to please contact Anita in the religious ed office for the details and to volunteer. Many thanks to the men and women participating at our blood drive that will be tomorrow at the parish hall. The drive goes until 1 p.m. You might still be able to make an appointment this evening or early tomorrow. Please check the parish website. As you know, walk-ins are not being permitted to help in the social distancing categories when they're drawing blood. Thank you so much for your attention.
Glorifying the Lord by your lives.